All right, new developments this morning in the race to develop a coronavirus vaccine. The human vaccine trial at Oxford University is now moving to the next phase of its trial. CNN's Clarissa Ward live in Oxford, where she's actually spoken to some of the volunteers for these trials. And Clarissa, these people really are human guinea pigs.
They really are. And, you know, honestly, what was so striking, John, is that they see this as a sense of duty, and they're excited to be participating in a study like this one, which, as you said, has just announced new human trials coming up. 10,000 people will be involved in those trials. Take a look.
It is the oldest university in the English-speaking world. But Oxford University may soon be better known for taking a big step forward in the global race to develop a vaccine against COVID-19. Graduate student Dan McAteer is one of more than 1,000 volunteers who signed up to be subjects in the first round of human trials. All participants had to be between 18 and 55 and in excellent health. Half were given the experimental COVID-19 vaccine, and half were given a control vaccine.
I, like all of us, felt very much impotent and powerless in the middle of the pandemic. So I thought, right, this sounds like maybe I can contribute in some way.
Mother of two, Lydia Guthrie, had her inoculation 3 weeks ago.
I did have a few moments beforehand of thinking, whoa, you know, I might be injected with this experimental vaccine. That sounds like something out of a science fiction film. But we're all having to make decisions about risk.
Guthrie says she experienced some side effects, similar to a mild flu. Next week, she will go back for her first blood test.
We have an e-diary system. So every day I get an email as a prompt to log in and complete a short questionnaire about my health and well-being. I also complete a questionnaire about my daily activities.
The vaccine's developers have made some bold predictions, saying it could be mass-produced as early as September. But some experts have cast doubt on that optimism, pointing to test results on monkeys. While none of the vaccinated animals suffered from pneumonia after being injected with COVID-19, they did still contract the virus. Jenner Institute Director Professor Adrian Hill says the data has been misconstrued.
We are very confident that the result in those monkeys was as good as we could have hoped for.
Is the goal of this vaccine to create immunity, or is it simply to prevent the worst symptoms?
So I think it'll either be one or the other. It doesn't work at all, or it works against infection and disease. That's generally how vaccines work.
McAteer concedes he will be disappointed if the vaccine doesn't work.
If you are part of something and you've given it your time, and it's been a subject of a bit of anxiety, of course, because there are risks attached, of course you want your vaccine to succeed. But fundamentally, we just need a vaccine to succeed, or even better, multiple vaccines to succeed.
In the end, the real race is against the virus and time.
So interesting to hear from these people, Clarissa. Tell us more about the next round of trials and who exactly will be tested.
So this is interesting, John, because in the first round, as you saw, it was people between 18 and 55. Now they're going to be expanding. They're going to be testing people even above 70 years old, and they're going to be looking at children potentially between the ages of 5 and 12. But some experts have said that we should be a little cautious about popping the champagne just yet. It simply is still very early. This is moving at a really quick pace. Those two subjects who we interviewed, they haven't even had their test results yet, and already you're talking about testing another 10,000 people. So some people saying, well, let's put the brakes on just a little bit and see what the data really shows.
That's right,
John.
Let the science work its course. Clarissa, really interesting look. Thanks so much for being with us.